Hi, I'm Marc.
And I'm Norene.
And we're operators and owners of the StoneCropAcres in Morrisburg, Ontario. We do a little bit more than just make wine. We actually view StoneCropAcres as a tourist destination. We have a B&B, we have a really nice little tasting room, we have a concert series. And in addition, we have this beautiful hall behind us that we use for weddings, birthdays, baby showers, just about anything you can think. So we're actually more than just winemakers, but we actually do make very nice wines, my dear Norene.
We do.
And she's the winemaker, and I'll let her talk a little bit about the wines.
What I'd like to do is give you a taste of what we would do for you if you came to our vineyard. I'm going to pour it into this glass, which is a standard tasting glass. And as you can see here, we have four of them lined up in our tasting caddies. When you come to the winery, we allow you to pick four wines, and we ask you to pick four wines, and then we'll present them to you in a tasting caddy so that you can see the wines, taste the wines, smell the wines all together. When you're actually tasting wines, you're using a standard tasting glass, which is 7 ounces, has a bowl in the bottom and a narrow top to keep the smells in so that you can smell them. And I will pour about a 1 or 2 ounce tasting into this. And as you can see, you can tell a lot by looking at a wine. This is sort of a salmon pinky gold color, which is in a sort of a south of France style rosé. It's clear, it's bright, it's not sparkling, but it's brilliant, which is what we like to say. And I'm holding it by the bottom. I have shaky hands from a tremor. So you can also hold it like this, but then I'm gonna look nervous. So I'm not gonna hold it like that. I'm gonna hold it like that. And it presents the wine well, and it keeps it cold in your glass, which we like to do for white and rosé wines. So next up, we've seen the wine. I have developed a process in my sommelier course called the 6 steps of wine tasting, and that's something that we play with a lot on the patio to make it fun. It doesn't matter if you know anything about wine. As long as you know what you like, and you have a nose and you have a mouth, and you can smell and taste a little bit, you can love wine. So our first step is see the wine, which we've done. Then we go on to sniff, swirl, sniff. Everybody wants to taste it. I'm like, hold on guys, be patient. So first you have to sniff without swirling. Most important thing, look smart. So I'm gonna sniff it. This is not a ladylike sniff. I put my nose right into the glass.
You look smart though.
I do look smart, that's true. Nose right in the glass. And I'm smelling strawberry rhubarb. I'm smelling a little bit of pink grapefruit. And I wanna smell more. So now I'm gonna swirl the glass a little bit. I'm shaking it up, I'm getting the aromas out of the wine. I'm gonna stick my nose back in. Ah, beautiful. Maybe a little bit of citrus, a little bit of apricot. So I'm gonna do that a little bit. And what my brain is doing now is it's engaging. It's going, well, this is cool. I smell stuff. Maybe I can taste it. But now I have a little bit of a view. And Jeannie's in the background, our dog, and she's playing with something, which is what she does, and she's making noise.
For what?
You'll meet her if you come to the winery. She's on the patio all the time. So I've smelled it, and now I'm going to do, so I've done a see the wine, I've done a sniff, swirl, sniff the wine, and now I'm going to do a sip, slurp, swish, and swallow, okay? So the first thing I'm going to do is sip a little bit. I usually say to people, don't do it with me. Wait until I show you so you don't choke and die on my patio. So the first thing we do is we take a sip and a slurp. I'm gonna pull air into my mouth, which is the same as swirling it in your glass, and it helps the air and the wine mix so you can sort of smell it and taste it together. And then I'm going to swish it around in my mouth like I'm doing Listerine or Scope. I'm gonna hold it on my tongue for a minute because that's where your taste buds are. Once it gets to your stomach, no taste buds in your stomach. So I'm gonna swish and swirl, and then I'm gonna slurp and swallow, okay?
You still look gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I've swallowed it. Now I'm just gonna think about how my mouth feels. How my mouth feels with this particular wine is crisp, and I'm salivating, and I can't wait to taste more. But my mouth had just woken up and it's gone, wow, what is this? So you can't really taste a wine until you've done this two or three times. So I'm going to do it one more time.
The second's the best.
What am I doing with my hand? I'm counting to five. And while I'm counting to five, I'm letting the wine swirl on top of my tongue. Let the taste buds have a good look at it. And I am getting on the palate that strawberry, rhubarb, pink grapefruit, a little bit of crisp apricot. It's beautiful, it's crisp. I can't wait to have some food with it. And then I've swallowed, of course, because I have to, because I wouldn't have been able to talk without swallowing. And when I swallow, now I'm talking about the finish of the wine. How long does it stay with you? Is it gone right away? Does it linger in your mouth for a little bit? Or does it just hang around there for a while? And that's called the finish, which can be short, medium, or long. And then you talk about what the finish tasted like. So it could be short and crisp, could be medium and fruity, could be long and luscious, whatever way you want to use it, doesn't matter. Use your imagination and talk about what you taste and you smell. The other thing I want to say is, number one, it doesn't take anything to know about wine to do this. And number two, everybody's different. Nobody has the same nose, nobody has the same palate. So you may get apricot and grapefruit, somebody else may get strawberry rhubarb. It doesn't mean you're wrong. It just means that you have different appreciations for the wine. I would love to have you come and visit us in SDNG. It's a wonderful place to live. It's a wonderful place to visit. We have such a good time at StoneCropAcres, and we can't wait to invite you here when things get back to normal. Thank you.
Thank you.
See you soon, SDG.